to the stage. We're going to ask them some questions. Can I introduce a cosplayer from Penang? She's been active for the last 3 or 4 years. She makes her own costumes and her props, and she's also a photographer. So this multi-talented lady, she's represented Malaysia in the World Cosplay Summit, which was held in Nagoya every single year, and she even got first runner-up in Les Midi's cosplay competition. May I introduce, come on over, Kyan Yu! Perfect, wonderful. Thank you very much. Kyan, what, as a judge today, what do you expect to see from the participants?
I'll definitely be happy to see like different kinds of creative skits and nice costumes and character portrayals.
Excellent. And what character are you dressed up today? Because you came out in full form.
I'm Super Sonico from Nitro Plus. She's a mascot of the company.
Excellent. Thank you very much. Round of applause for Kyan Yu, please. And our next judge, you may know him from the workshop earlier. He's somebody who is no stranger to the cosplay industry in Malaysia. And he's also an avid prop maker. He has the skills to make pieces of foam and pieces of plastic turn into armor. Can I introduce to the stage, John Deodara.
Thank you.
Well, earlier, John, we had a little chat. You gave everybody this fabulous workshop tutorial earlier. And also, do you have anything that you're going to look out for in the competition later?
Okay, costume-wise, I'm going to be checking on your construction and whether your costume looks presentable on stage. Performance-wise, if you can pull off a good skit, that'd be good enough. I'll give you some nice marks for that one.
Thank you very much, John. Also known as Deodara, also known as the prop making genius in Malaysia. And finally, can I bring to the stage? She's been walking around and being photographed non-stop today. She made her very first costume in 2009. Actually, I heard this story. She didn't actually make it. She wasn't actually the first one. Her mommy made it. And then after that, she realized that she wanted to do it herself. So can I bring to the stage the woman who's done it all for fun, passion, and self-discovery? Somebody who's picked up sewing tutorials and made some incredible outfits. Kizuma Zem! One of our judges today. Hi, Kizuma.
Hi. Kizuna,
there we go. Thank you very much. Tell me, what are you dressed as today? What, who, when, where?
I'm dressing as Akamushi from Time Machine. Actually, it is a manga.
Yeah. Actually, you're dressed up as a manga character. Amazing.
It is Akamushi.
And does Akamushi have any secret powers or secret skills?
Okay, sorry about that. He is not a human. He's non-human. He has some ability to summon spiders. Yeah.
I think that's a massive skill. If you can summon spiders and summon little insects and summon anything, that's awesome. Thank you very much. Judges, our esteemed judges, please have a seat. And we'll begin our group competition. Mentioned earlier,
whoa.
We'll be starting our group competition, and let me tell you a bit about the prizes, why everybody is here today at SOX 2014's Fantasy Fest, your ultimate fest for cosplay, anime, and games. The reason everybody is here today, and if you're up there, hi! If you're getting a better view up there, it's because we're having our group cosplay competition, and our winners today will 100 ringgit. First runner-up will go home with 200 ringgit, and the champion will go home with 400 ringgit. All of these people, including the top five, will get travel allowances to KL for the finale, where they'll compete for 1,500 ringgit and iPhone 5S. So, without further ado, let's get the show started. Contestants, are you ready? So to start off our group competition, let's bring onto stage a group called OLCG. They are playing characters Draven and Annie, and they are a duo where they're from the series LOL. Can I introduce to the stage Lim Song Yi and Carmen Lee? Come on over.
Stand back. and everything.
No, it's well, not just this, but we had a show for definitely.
Right, so he says they never practice at all, so it's all spontaneous. I like how you have an American accent in your skit just now, it's very realistic. And also for you, Annie, I like how you said size does not matter. How long have you worked on your costume?
Oh,
you purchased your costume, but you put everything together, right? Well done. Can we have some comments from our esteemed judges, please?
Hello, Draven.
Hi, yeah.
If Draven fought Draven, would Draven beat Draven? So, your props, your weapons, what materials are they?
Material is mounting board, PVC pipe, and EVA prop.
Very nice paint job, especially it's very flexible, you can use for fighting and skin.
Oh, thank you.
The one thing I couldn't stop looking away from is the wig. Like, no matter what you do, the wig stays in place. That is quite awesome work.
我讲华语OK啊，可以吗？用了多久做头发跟道具？这个头发跟道具应该是两天了，头发应该是两个钟头。哦，我就拿那个粘木的那个粘上。粘木的，粘木的，粘木的。Annie，你们可以，你们可以，我一直加分，你们。啊，你们练习多久？没有练习。
所以今天剪得很差，不错。嗨，我觉得是有一点点可以再加强，可能是 timing 的方面，只是我很喜欢 Raven 的 prop， 因为他怎样甩他都不会掉，然后零件都不会掉，就很 solid， 很好看。反正我喜欢 Annie 的，很可爱的，因为我自己本身做不了这种比较 moe 的 collection， 所以我就很羡慕这种可以做 moe 的。
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much, judges, and thank you very much, Draven and Annie. Next onto the stage, can we have our second group, please? Coming from Penang Kamen Rider's Cosplay Club, can I introduce to stage Un Ern Heng, Tan Li Lun, Adil Fadlan bin Muat Johari, as Kamen Rider Decade, Kamen Rider Nigo, and Kamen Rider Kuga!
Yeah.
When I look at it, later I use 3 and 4 months of editing. Thanks to my friends that teach me how to edit, and then I work hard, and then this is what you're looking at.
Excellent, a round of applause please.
Including my friends as well as you look at it.
Yeah, would you like to comment on our Kamen Rider Kuga over there?
Okay, yeah, he's the first founder in Penang. Later on, he inspired me, and then thanks to him, he really teach me how to use materials alone by using less money, doing all these editing stuff, all this. And then on my Ichigo, he's one of the hardest from A to Z, all by his work.
Excellent! And judges, can we have some words, please, on our fabulous dancing duo?
Trio lah.
Trio.
Can you headshot?
Oh yeah.
Dikit.
Again.
Salahkan dikit.
Hold your belt. Oh, absolutely. So we've got our transforming trio.
At least it makes it sound. And Kamen Rider number two. Transform, Henshin. Thank you. At least old school still rules.
Yeah.
Especially with your music choice. Okay, so talking about craftsmanship, great work on the costumes. Always good to see nice Kamen Rider costumes. The kid, very nice. I've spoken to you before. Very good work, especially when you've got a broken costume, you have to fix it up. I know how hard it is, especially if it's a lot of damage. Kuga, very nice. Smooth paint job, everything nice. Good helmet. Is it all made by you or what?
With some help with my friend.
Kawan-kawan tolong kan?
We do the thing together.
Sama-sama lah. Okay. Very nice lights in your helmet. Kamen Rider 2.
Yeah, thank you.
For performance-wise, I would have liked to see for a dancing skit and then stuff like that, you can actually compress it shorter and make it more snappy. Like instead of just going around the stage like that, you can actually come out to the front, stand near the edge and like dance more. I know it's a bit hard in armor and stuff, but you can pull the audience in if you do nicer dance moves and stuff like that. It's fine, you can practice. But song-wise, everything's fine. It's a Kamen Rider is for kids. It's to help make kids happy and stuff. So I guess that helps.
Okay.
And from our judge, Kaien Yu.
Okay, so I'm gonna say something. I like Decade because you're pink.
Thank you.
I'm pink too.
Unfortunately, I have to say it's not pink, it's magenta.
Okay. I'm gonna minus marks.
But it's the truth, but okay, but I also like pink, seriously.
And then I like Kuga's shape. The whole shape of the armor is really nice. And then I also like Nigo's performance. Nigo's like the main character in front row, you guys are like the backup dancers. I like how into character he was.
Thank you very much.
And finally from our judge, Kizuna.
Hi, I think that maybe you can blend your henshin into your performance. I think it will look more funky and funny. Yeah, and more attractive. Thank you. And I like your performance. It's amazing.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, judges. And thank you very much, Kamen Rider. Decade. Thank you very much, Kamen Rider Kuga and Kamen Rider Nigo. Now we have our third group and our final group cosplay for the competition. Can I bring to the stage Ho Fu Lin, Ho Xian Lin, Tan Pei Wun, and Cho Geng Liu coming on as Luffy, an original character, and Karuta, and another Karuta. Please.
Well, this car could be systematic, hydromatic, ultramatic. Let's go.
know what? I think they can be called the Grease Ladies. All of them are completely different characters. We've got two Karutas and we've got one Luffy. And we've got one original character. So I'm quite curious who this original character is. So I'm going to go over there. Hi! So what's the name of your original character?
Kitty.
Kitty.
That's it.
Luffy says she's a fake kitty. What is your superpower?
Cute.
That's it.
A superpower is being cute. I would agree with that. And Karuta, we spoke earlier, you have a great costume. What's the difference between the two?
This is the maid's costume and this is the school costume.
Excellent. And I have Luffy at the end over there, our most passionate Grease Lightning dancer. Tell me more about your costume, Luffy.
Hey, this is the original costume. The Luffy original costume.
Fantastic.
But I'm the girl version.
Thank you very much. And judges, can I have some comments please on our Grease ladies over here?
Yeah, I'm always going first. Okay, performance wise, great. You guys are having fun. That's the best part. So the audience, big clap for them. This is what performance art should be. It's like fun. Just enjoy yourself. Costume-wise, Luffy, very nice. Original costume, not time skip one.
Thank you.
Karuta, very nice both versions. Very in character, Poppy Box. Kitty.
Fat Kitty.
I can't really, I don't have reference, but still good costume.
Thank you.
Great performance. I love Grease Lightning. Great musical, love the movie, very nice.
Thank you very much.
This song, let's call it, it's a nostalgia bomb. It's really good to actually see a full choreographed performance to a full dance. Because I haven't seen any good proper full dancers for skits in a long time, especially one to a classic song like this. What gave you the inspiration for this? Why did you want to do it?
This song gave us very enjoy and fun. So I'm very happy to dance this song.
Exactly what I wanted to hear.
Most of the things that I'm gonna say is already said by John. So I love how you guys enjoy your performance. Yeah. Thank you.
And Kizuna.
I enjoy the performance also. I feel like, my head keeps going. My head is going to fall down.
We're going to let the judges deliberate for a few minutes and we're going to begin our open category competition for the cosplay competition. As I mentioned earlier, we're here at the SOX 2014 Fantasy Fest. Fantasy Fest. And we're going to be starting with our group competition. Actually, that's just completed. We're going to be starting with our open category competition in a few minutes.